Good morning children, this is your social science class. Today we are going to see understanding secularism in civics. This is your unit 3. So in this chapter you come to know about the meaning of secularism, importance of secularism, importance of secular education, all these things. So what is meant by secularism? Yes, it is a philosophy that rejects all form of religious faith and worship. So everyone is equal under the eyes of God, right? We are equal. Though we follow any other religion, many religions are followed in our country, we are equal in the eyes of God, right? So religion must not divert ourselves, must not divide any enmity towards ourselves. So that is the main philosophy of this secularism, main theme of this secularism. India is a land of multi-religious faith and multicultural beliefs. So we all know we are following many religious festivals. We have many cultures, right? So India is a land of multi-religion. It is a birthplace of major religions, Hinduism, Jainism, Buddhism and Sikhism. So these four religions have been started from India. It is a birthplace of these four major religions. In our country, people of diverse religions and belief have been living peacefully for a long time. Though we are following many religions, though we are having many belief, we are living peacefully. For a very long time, Indians are living peacefully, right? The concept of secularism is aimed at creating a society in which people of religious beliefs or people who do not belong to any religion can live together in harmony and peace. So they can live together unitedly and peacefully. Okay, though we belong to any religion, we can live like that, right? Rajaram Mohan Roy, Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, Rabindranath Tagore, Mahatma Gandhi and B.R. Ambedkar were some of the noted individuals held high in public regards who contributed toward the spread of secularism in various spheres of Indian society. So these persons all, they contributed toward the spread of secularism. Okay, so all are equal. Though we follow any religion, we are brothers and sisters. In our pledge also, we used to say, right? So these people, they contributed a lot for the spread of secularism. Secularism means an attitude of tolerance towards other religions and peaceful coexistence of citizens belonging to different faiths. So we have to tolerate, we have to accept other religious faith also, right? Every citizen is free to propagate, practice, change it or have one according to their conscience. So every citizen, they are free to propagate about their religion. Okay, they are free to say about their religious faith and they can practice anything whichever is given in the holy. Okay, we'll see about the objectives of secularism. One religious group does not dominate another. So one religion group, we have many religious group, right? So one group should not dominate, should not control the other group. Some members don't dominate other members of the same religious community. So in some religion, they'll be following the same religion, but some people will be considered higher and others will be as lower. So the domination will be in their same religion also. So that is also should not be practiced. This is one of the main theme of secularism. A simple statement by poet Iqbal illustrates the secular view. Religious does not teach us animosity. We are Indians and India is our home. So a famous poet Iqbal says that religion does not teach us animosity, which means enmity. None of the religion will teach us enmity. Will any religion says that we should hate others? Though we are following Hinduism, Christianism, Jainism, Buddhism, Muslim, Islamic, whatever we follow, none of the religion is asking to dislike others, right? Hate others. So all the religions are teaching something good for us, right? So religion will not teach us enmity. We are Indian, and India is our home. We are all living in our same home, same country only. Right. So we'll see the characteristic feature of a secular state. Principle of liberty. The state permits the practice of any religion. So we can practice any religion. We have the freedom. People of principle of equality. The state does not give preference to any religion over another. So all are equal. Okay, it does not give first preference to one religion or not to the other, not like that. Okay, no domination or no controlling over the other religions. Principle of neutrality. The state remains neutral in religious matters. So the state, it must be neutral. It should be balanced. Okay, it should not show any partiality towards other religions and all. We'll see about the importance of secularism. The concept of secularism evolved in India as equal treatment of all religions. So all the religious people must be equally treated. So that is very important, right? So there is no state religion in India. As children, so we are living in Tamil Nadu state, but here we see all sort of religious people, right? Hindu, Muslim, Christians, Jain people. As if you go to Karnataka also, we see all sort of religious people. In some other state, many religious people are surviving together, living together. So there is no any particular state for some religion, right? So secularism is very important in our country. So we'll see why secularism, that education, secular education is important. Secular education is needed to develop moral and humanistic outlook. So everyone must be treated equally. A moral and humanistic, humanity must be, okay, to treat mankind in a very good manner. To train the youth to be a good citizen. So to train the youngsters to be a good citizens, okay. To give wider version towards life, to give wider vision, okay, life, to they'll learn many things about the life, to develop an attitude of appreciation and understanding of other points of view. So but when we when we learn the secularism, we'll try to appreciate others' attitude also. Others will give respect to others' point of view also. To develop the spirit of love, tolerance, cooperation, equality and sympathy. So we can develop all these good qualities. So in India, the Indian state works in various ways to prevent religious domination. So India is working very hard to prevent religious domination. Secularism undoubtedly helps and aspires to enable every citizen to enjoy full blessings of life, liberty and happiness. So each and every citizen must enjoy liberty, happiness, peacefulness, everything he must enjoy. And finally, we can read a poem, okay, written by Kabir. So he has written that God is asking the followers, okay, his followers, "Ho follower, where do you search for me?" So the God is asking, "Why, where you are searching for me? I am with you." So God is with us only, not in pilgrimage, not in any holy place, nor in any statues or nor in any icons, neither in solitude. I am not isolated, I am not alone, nor in temples, nor in mosque, neither in Kaaba, which means a holy place for the Muslims, okay, the in Mecca, not in Kailash for Hindus. I am with you, O man, I am with you. So God is with us only. This is what Kabir is telling. So followers, no need to search for me anywhere in holy places. I am with you, I am in your heart alone. So this is what the poet says. Okay. So the secularism compels people to respect other religions. It grants equal rights that people in respect of other religious faith. It is desirable for a country like India. So we all should welcome it. We all should receive it in a proper way. We should be very proud that we are living in a secular country. Okay, this is what the lesson says, children. I hope you would have understand this. Thank you.